Good morning, children. Welcome back to our Sanjeeva's e-class. Children, already you have watched my previous videos also. Hope you are completing the notes on time. Today we are going to start the civics, that is lesson number 3, Indian Constitution. In last class, you have learnt about the democratic country. You have learnt why democratic country, India needs a democratic republic and many things. Now let's study what is our constitution. Proceeding further, let's read the textbook and understand deeply. Heli, Priyanshi and Sachin are watching the final match of the World Cup 2011 on TV with their parents. An exciting match is going on between India and Sri Lanka. Who will win the World Cup, India or Sri Lanka? Sri Lanka had put up a challenging target for India to achieve, but the fearless batting of Indian captain, that is Mahendra Singh Dhoni, India won the World Cup. Everyone was rejoicing in victory. Heli said to her mother while watching TV, "Mummy, the previous match between England and India resulted into a tie. What does that mean?" Meeta Ben said, "Heli, for a popular game like cricket, the ICC has systematically formed a rule. A tie in a match means that both the teams have an equal score. Even the games like football, hockey, kabaddi, etc. have their own set of rules. If a game has so many rules, then to run the administration of a popular nation, we surely require well-framed rules." It's true, children. For example, when you are in Xavier's, when you open the handbook of our school, there are some rules and regulations that we have to follow, and we are following. Yes, aap padhne honge, koi log padhte nahi, par aap padho ki isme kya kya likha hai. We have to frame it, children. Any institution, there are some rules and regulations. We have to strictly follow it. Now, this is the preamble, children. What do you mean by preamble? It is something that we are going to start. It is something that shows some purpose. It is a, suppose we are writing some book or some written documents are there. For what purpose it is being written? That purpose is called preamble. We see the people of India having solemnly resolved to constitution India into sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political liberty of thought, expression, belief, will and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all the fraternity, assuring the dignity of individual and the unity and the integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to the ourselves this constitution. So this is the first page of it. Now, a systematic comparison of set of rules to run the government of a country is known as a constitution of the country. You can underline this sentence also. Constitution can be written or unwritten form. Or constitution starts with the preamble. So you can just see the pics, okay? The preamble. Moving further, how was the Constitution of India formed? Kaisa bana tha? Kisne banaya? Who were the people behind this hard work? Let's see. The Constitution of India is a statement of national goals and aims and such as democracy, socialism, secularism, unity, etc. The Constituent Assembly was established. It started working from 9 December 1946. The Constituent Assembly was formed of the prominent and distinguished scholars and leaders. Their political vision and foresight was incorporated in the Constitution. Leaders like Jawaharlal Nehru, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Sardar Patel, Maulana Azad, Kalam Azad, Shyam Prasad, Mukherjee, Sardar Baldev Singh, etc. provided their guidance. Frank Anthony represented the Anglo-Indian community and H.P. Modi represented the Parsi community. The community had various constitutions scholars like Aladi Krishna Swami, Iyer, Dr. B. R. Ambedkar, P. M. Munshi, etc. These are the some people who have been a guidance for this constitution. They were female members like Sarojini Naidu and Vijayalakshmi Pandit. Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected as the president of the Constituent Assembly. They were a number of subcommittees to take care of various aspects of constitution. The drafting committee, which was headed by B. R. Ambedkar, gave to the constitution a final shape. Total 166 meetings were held by Constituent Assembly in a time period of 2 years, 11 months and 18 days. On 26 November 1949, the committee passed the constitution, which was enforced on 26 January 1950. So children, the constitution banane mein kitna time laga tha? Total 166 meetings hue the. They need the period of 2 years, 11 months and 18 years to give a final shape to the constitution. And it was enforced on 26 January 1950. But on 26 November 1949, the committee passed the constitution. Passed kiya tha sabke. Haan, sabko anumati. Se matlab ye, haan, okay, it is ready. Now we can enforce on 26 January 1950, which is known as Republic Day. So these are the pictures of our leaders. They are the creators of our constitution. So children, I will be explaining why we need the constitution to run our country in next video. Till then, stay safe. Thank you.